Hello viewers, welcome to educators.com. This is Venkatram Nagandi. In the previous session, we have discussed about so what is a spinner view and how to work with spinner views. So in this topic, we are going to discuss about what is a menu in our Android, how to create a menu, what are the different types of menus available for us in the Android. So now, what is a menu? Most of the times in our real world, so we heard this word when you go to a restaurant or maybe coffee shop. So like any hotel or whatever, such kind of places. So what do you find? So always we look for so the familiar mechanism to find out what exactly you are looking for. Like everything has been categorized properly. So whether if you are a vegan, you just go for vegetarian menu and choose whatever you want. So and beverages, starters, main course, something like that. Everything has been categorized properly. Assume. So if it is not categorized, a big board is there. Sometimes you will, if you go to any caves, you'll find it. A small shops, you'll find that kind of a big board with all the items. You have to search what you want. So means here the menus will create a familiar and consistent user experience. Okay. And which we use to display the options that cannot directly visible on the main UI of our application. So traditionally dedicated menu is there previously till 2.3.3. So from Android 3.0 onwards, so there is no menu button in our Android. So to be say frankly, except Samsung, no other is phone have phone having the menu button nowadays. So Samsung, they are following their own structure or their own prototype. So no other Android device is having a menu button that is called as a D-pad, the bottom center you'll find in your real devices. So now thereafter the sixth item menu also has been deprecated and which has been placed with app bar. So this is what is a menu. Now let us see what are the different types of menus available for us. So we have the options menu and context menu. Of course we have pop-up menu also. But here we will discuss about options menu and context menu. So options menu is the primary collection of the menu items for an activity. So where the actions has been global impact on the application, where that must be placed in a options menu. Okay, so the just example like whatever the app you open, you defaultly find search button. And if you go to mailing application, so all the way you'll find the compose button. And at the top of your app bar, okay, and settings also. For every application, you'll find this. So settings and search very commonly. We'll discuss in detail about the options menu in the next session. So context menu. So this is something like a right click in your desktop applications, but we cannot, we do not have any right click in our mobiles, right? So how do we handle them? So this is a floating menu which will appear when the user perform a long click on any element, so that pops up your context menu. Now let us see how to create a menu resource. So Android providing a familiar way to create a menu resource out of your UI. Okay, so then we'll refer that according to the requirement. A menu resource defines an application menu, either it is your options menu or context menu or whatever the menu you create. So we will define our menu items in the menu resource. And where it is a good, always a good practice to define a menu and its item in a XML menu resource, because why we should do that? So it is very easier to visualize your menu options, and which is completely separate your content from the main UI thread, and which allows us to create a alternative menu configurations depends upon your screen size, orientation and the density of the screen. And it is going to define a, so if you want to create a menu resource, just define a menu in your resource direct resources slash menu. So defaultly in olden days till 4.3 it used to get a menu directory defaultly, but now we are not getting menu directory defaultly. So under resource directory, create a menu folder, inside that place your XML file. Now let us see what does this XML file, XML main resource contains. So this XML main resource is going to contain menu, item, and group. So this menu tag or menu element is the root tag, which holds all of your menu items, or it may hold group also. So here item is going to create a menu item, which will represent a single item in the menu, and it may contain a nested menu also to create the sub menu. Okay, and even the group. So even a menu contains a group also, but which is an invisible container for your item elements. So which allows to categorize the menu items. Something like just now I told you, right? So all of your vegetarian item has been categorized to one part, and all the non-vegetarian has been categorized into one part. So grouping something. So now let us see what an item attributes are there. What an item element contains. Item element defaultly, the mostly used attributes of the item element are Android ID, Android icon, Android title, and show as action attributes. So even of course we have more attributes available, but these we use very commonly and which are important. So Android ID attribute is going to create a resource ID to identify which menu item the user has been clicked. And Android icon is going to refer your drawable file for your item icon to display an icon. And the title, which is going to be the name of your menu item, which refers to a string file. And Android show as action, this is a plays a key role actually. So specifies when and how this item should be appear as an action item in the app bar. So you see here, like there are some properties, never, always, show if room, means if the place is available, the option will be visible to the user. If there is no place, something like that, it is going to be completely iconic based. Okay, so this is what all about menus in our Android. So thanks for watching educators.com. Let's catch up in the next session and we'll discuss about options menu.